Hello, I'm Bob Ross, and I'd like to welcome you to episode 1 of Inside the Triple Llama, a CamannWordsmith production. Now, we won't be venturing inside a llama, let alone 3 llamas. No, Inside the Triple Llama is a look at how CamannWordsmith records music. So when you're ready, get comfortable. And Raphael, cue the music. The theme music for this web series. Be back in a second.
Fix the verse just in time. Reverb at 4 or 5. Gotta rep the new mix by 8 a.m. Drums first, then the guitar. The wordsmith's working hard to record the best art he can for you. Well, you know what I've been told. You need a full band to run this show. And I can't do this all on my own. But I kinda do. And I'll show you how at the Triple Llama. I can't write a song.
So, today we are going to talk about the acoustic guitar. It's portable, it's beautiful, it's versatile, it is other things that end with all. Joseph, why don't you tell us about your guitar?
So this is an Alvarez Yari WY-112. It's a Bob Weir model. It's actually the 12-string version of the guitar that Ani DeFranco plays. Because it's a collaboration between two companies, it's got some quirks. It is designed to essentially restring it all at once. If you replace, like, say, the G string, before tuning that up to the proper pitch, you need to detune all the other strings as well. This is an acoustic electric guitar, so it can be played without a microphone or directly. I actually do both, and we're going to show you that now.
There is a pickup installed inside it, and it allows me to control the volume. It gives me some degree of control over the tone.
Now, part of the problem that I have recording a guitar like this is that 9-volt battery-powered pickup, that's what's called a piezo pickup. When used with exactly the right equipment, it can produce this amazing, incredible, beautiful tone. Unfortunately, I do not have that type of equipment, and most people who record in my price range don't. It actually comes out sounding pretty terrible. The way that we have solved this is with this device, which is a Fishman Platinum Pro, and this does a couple different things. That volume control that you saw on the acoustic guitar, even when that is at a very low level, even when it's on a 1 out of 10, for example, it has a signal that is very, very strong and very overpowering.
That cable that we plugged into the guitar, we can plug the other end into the quarter-inch jack here, and that will take it to the audio interface. We also have control over tone, which is really nice. I use this both for my guitar and for my bass. We have played a note or a chord. It has gone into the Fishman, and then it is going to go into this. This is an audio interface. Mine happens to be an Audient ID 14. That jack that you see on the left-hand side marked DI, that is direct input. I use that for primarily electric guitars. We are instead going to record through the jacks on the back, which are XLR. Those are the microphone inputs that you see there. And the Audient is processing the signal and then sending it to my computer. What we're actually going to do is have both the direct guitar signal and the mic'd guitar signal recording at the same time. When we blend those together, that is going to give us a rather nice tone. So about 90% of the time, what you're hearing on my acoustic recordings is a combination of a microphone input and a direct input. This is the microphone that I use to capture the acoustic guitar. It is a small condenser microphone that is designed primarily for instruments. This microphone we want to have positioned right around here, like the 14th fret. Contrary to popular belief, you do not generally want that to be directly pointed into the sound hole. On acoustic recording guitar days, that can take probably 15 to 20 minutes to just position it exactly where it should be, and it's a lot of trial and error. This program is what's called a DAW, Digital Audio Workstation. My preferred one, the one I'm using right now, is called Studio One. Let's hear some guitar as recorded through the microphone. It is a very nice tone, Joseph, but I wish it had a little more bass. Why don't we see what it sounds like using the 9-volt pickup and the cable that you plug directly into the guitar? That was also very nice, Joseph, but it's missing a little something. What would happen if we put the two tracks together? Now, you said that fisherman thingy can change the tone of the guitar. Now, with both guitar tracks recorded, you're done, aren't you? No. That's assuming also that I actually record the guitar correctly in one take, which rarely happens. So the first thing that we want to do is take the two guitar tracks that we've recorded and send them to what is called a bus. That is a different track that combines these two tracks together into one. Add bus for selected channels. Bus 1 has been renamed Acoustic Guitar Bus. On the right-hand side, you can see a number of different effects. To make things easy, we are going to use something called Pod Farm from line 6. Now I'm going to drag Pod Farm over to the bus I created, and that opens this fancy little thing. It's got all kinds of different effects, different settings, a number of really popular songs, so you can try and mimic those tones that the original musicians used. This is an acoustic guitar, so we are going to want an acoustic guitar setting. And oh look, we've got some reverb, a compressor, some EQ, a noise gate. I can click on any of these. Now our guitar has some compression, it's got some EQ, it's got some reverb, and let's see what it sounds like. And so there we have it, Acoustic Guitar Basics at the Triple Llama Studios. Thank you so much to CamannWordsmith patrons for supporting this series and making it possible. We'll see you again in episode 2.